was contemplating what we were going to talk about this hour, looking at the news, discussing the same old boring COVID garbage that everybody talks about, because that's all there is to talk about. Because they don't want us focusing on anything else. That's obvious. If they really cared, you know, they're starting to slip in a little bit of the election, but overall, in general, they've kept us laser focused on the boogie-woogie virus. And between the lockdown and some of the minor restrictions being lifted, they make it sound like it's going back to normal. Maybe it is. Maybe it is going back to normal. I don't believe that myself. But maybe gradually we'll get back to normal. But do we really want to go back to normal? You see, folks, we're at a turning point. We could go back to the life that was. That's what's at least being hinted at, that we can just go back with minor changes to our lifestyle, a little more social distancing, wearing masks, but you can have all that life back eventually down the road, gradually. You can have all that back. But do we really want to have all that back? Look what that brought us. It brought us to a lockdown where it shows, at least publicly, that the people weren't prepared for anything like this. The state governments weren't prepared. The federal government, nobody was prepared for this. Except for the sordid few who were in on some simulations and watched and hoped for these kind of things. And I do believe they hoped for it. Because all of a sudden there's a geek out there that is the expert. And then that's really funny. Experts aren't experts anymore. It's people who the media projects as experts. But as far as I can tell, Mr. Bill Gates, he doesn't have a background per se. Well, he might actually, with, you know, the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation and their participation, their organization of Event 201, which we've covered here before. If you don't know what that is, please go to our website, www.jaylabang.com, and find out more about that event. But getting back to the point I was making earlier about the turning point. See, if they eventually release these restrictions and we can go back to what would be considered normal life, how good was that? We still had the corruption in the government. Is that what you want? Do you want to continue? Do you want to go back to that? Because going back to normal, which I'm hearing a lot of people clamor for, and I understand it has disrupted everybody's life, their behavior. But instead of learning from this, instead of committing to making some solutions so this never happens again, everybody just wants to go back to normal. And that wasn't a great system. Normal wasn't great for the little guy. Normal was great for the rich, the elite, the politicians. Anybody who benefited from the makeup of the model of the current system. A system that doesn't base itself off of a constitution anymore. And as we've seen with the lockdowns, what constitution is there? That's been trampled upon. We've got state governors restricting travel where they are definitely overstepping their bounds. We've got a federal government led by Donald Trump who, for the sake of whatever, are forcing industries to convert or stay open, which is extremely troubling that the president is going to use another, what was that, the Industrial Protection Act or whatever they call it, part of the executive orders I spoke about, what, weeks ago now, where they can take over industries at will. That's what they're doing. And now they're telling the meat processors, the chicken and the beef and the pork, and they have to stay open even though they want to close now because they've had outbreaks. You understand that the president is trying to secure the food chain for the people. At least that's the way it looks on the face of it. And there'll be a lot of people who say that's good. But it's dictatorial-ish. It's no different than the state governor, like Governor Whitless Gretchen in Michigan, who imposed all these dictatorial powers. She's relaxed a few. And the people think that that's changed anything. It's pretty interesting how she relaxed a couple of minor restrictions, but then extended through the middle of May, the stay-at-home order. So she gave you a little nugget, all you in Michigan, she gave you a little nugget and took more away, took another 2 weeks away from you. It's hard to blame the governments. They weren't ready for this. So when this stuff comes down, there's only one thing they can do is impose their will on you. Because nobody was ready for this. But as I go through the journey of this show today, I want to get your input about the turning point that I'm going to be talking about. Because it's a lot different than the turning point most people out there are talking about. We've got people going to the extreme that even the Antichrist is on the verge of showing himself. There's evidence that they use, circumstantial evidence, but they use it to make a pretty good argument for their case, but everybody or most people who are talking about actual turning points are either talking about turning points to the negative, war, famine, but all this other stuff, or it's turning points on more government control. Many of you feel that they've got us in a position to where they could do almost anything to us. If they were to back down now on their encroachment on our freedoms, it would almost be negligent on their part. They're on the verge of doing just that. All we need is a little push. But in doing so, they've exposed themselves to us. And I believe that a turning point could go the other way, but it really depends on how we as a people react to their powers, to their movements. I'm sort of a counterpuncher when I do games, and or even when I've gotten into scraps back in the day, I'm a counterpuncher. I wait for the aggressor to do their thing, because I'm never going to be the aggressor. I always thought that was the American way, too. We're not the aggressor. That's why we call it national defense. We don't call it national offense. You know? We're supposed to be a nation that counterpunches. We're going to leave you alone. I mean, that isn't what has transpired over the past couple decades with the leadership of the country. But in general, that's how I've taken the American way when it comes to military action, when it comes to protecting yourself. It's always I'm not going to be the aggressor, but you aggress on me, you come at me. Same with our country. We're going to nail you, and we're going to nail you hard because you should have left me alone because I left you alone. Well, I think this turning point we could use to our own advantage. We're so close to, if we could just hold this out on our end and actually shut down, and I'm not talking about like the May 1st protesting against corporations, you know, the people's power, that communist movement type stuff. If we really, really wanted to get a solution so that this could never happen again, and I'm talking about being unprepared when a virus or when anything, because if we're unprepared for a virus and it was 20 years ago, or just under 20 years ago, that we were unprepared for airliners crashing into buildings. All that money in defense seems to be going to waste. All the trillions of dollars. If we can't be prepared for eventualities. Now you, me, everybody watching, everybody who may discuss this subject after the fact, and I hope you do, because we could really, and as we go along, I'm almost on a break here, so we'll get to most of this in the second and third and fourth segments as I expand on my idea here. I wanted to set it all up for you. But I think the turning point could be used in our favor. And it's because of the circumstances they brought on us that we might as well see the sucker through now and push them back. Because in their overreaching on the federal, state levels, even counties and local and your local government city levels, in all of their overreaching, they've exposed themselves. And I think we could make a huge difference if we take what is coming. There's an eventual turning point coming. It's which way we want to go. We'll expand on that as we continue the show. Stay tuned, folks. We'll be right back.